My name is Wabene Elikem Fiachi, the founder and artistic director of Purple Chris International Artist Residency here in Kumasi. I identify as a trans vata, though people call me trans woman. Growing up and also discovering my own orientations, both gender and sexually, I think there is always a kind of seeking for validation and legitimacy from the cultural environment, which I want to defile. I have always seen an exclusion as a form of alienation, isolation, reject. And in that way, I have seen myself struggling and navigating a society that is largely heteronormative and culturally binary. The bank and the financial institutions have been the biggest nightmare when it comes to an exclusion here living in Ghana. Anytime I have to do banking directly in the banking hall, I'm always being discriminated against. Even to just change my ATM card when it expired, it took me for almost 4 months to get that done because they wouldn't. I went to several other branches and my name has been blacklisted. I went to Accra, my name has been blacklisted. I went to the headquarters. They refer me back to Kumasi, where my bank is, and still my name was blacklisted. People may also take it for granted that, oh, it's just a security measure and a protocol they are following. But this is a total lie because most of my ID cards are biometric. Secondly, I have other supporting documents, some of which have my identity written there as female, and my passport picture and everything be me. When I got into the bank like this, presenting my passport to withdraw money on a counter, and then they look in the passport, is like, who is this? I'm like, this is me. And who is that? That is me. Who are you? This is me. You know, and then I will say, this is me, that is me. And this is one passport, that was another passport. So these are two different passports. I'm always carrying like 4 ID cards on me, 2 national passports, and then 3 other ID cards. Because I always have to show people that, look, I wouldn't have been able to go and steal 5 ID from one person to come and present to you for a transaction. So this is my document, this is me. And so, in this bank, it took them more than 2 hours to engage me in that conversation and the conversation. At the end, they denied me the transaction. I left to another bank. It was the same story. It's very frustrating when I am excluded. Very, very frustrating. Very depressive. I remember the recent one, I had to walk for 2 hours. I would say aimlessly on the streets just to empty myself with that, from that bad, out of that bad energy that I experienced. Because 5 hours there, being left in suspense, no one was talking to me, no one was telling me anything. They only go come back and ask for the next ID, go come back and ask for the next ID. And then they tell me bank has closed. And after bank is closed, they cannot do anything for me. So I feel like online become a safe space for some of us to financially navigate the spaces around us. To feel included is to strip the bank immediately from binary data collection. It can only be achieved if we are able to have either one-on-one conversation with people who are in power, people who are responsible for such facilities, or we are able to continue an advocacy that brings a lot of awareness and people understand the existence of people like me.